Welcome to my show, my third show at Bowery Gallery. The name of the show is Back on Land, and this is a piece called The Twig and Twain. These works span from the last 4 years or so, the 2015 up to 2019. The show began February 26th and continues to March 23rd, and consists mostly of what I'm calling image poems. These landscapes are done en plein air, and there are just a few of those directly perceived tableaus, as the majority of the works are more of an invented nature. This is a painting called River Call. These three paintings sort of go together. They're all based on a main street in Farmington, and have family portraits within them. At least these two have that shared element. And then the one on the end is more of an interior scene, but is also based on family. These three paintings also go together well, although they're not intended as a triptych. But this central painting is called Wonderwall, and shows a view of the campus, Miss Porter's school. On the left is the painting called Back on Land, and that refers somewhat to being back on land after being on the water when I was a crew coach from 99 to 2013. This one's called Palio, or The Return. These are some details from those paintings. And then on the wall to the right are three paintings that also seem to have a relationship with each other. The one on the left is called Tabora and the Western Cycle, followed by a painting called Emmaus, and then a painting called Intermission. This painting was done in the late winter of 2018, before Ruth and I went to San Francisco. It dates back to summer before last. Some dancers in a space separated from an image of Christ after entombment, and then finally a suggestion of a resurrected figure in the deepest space of the landscape. This one called Intermission was inspired by the class I was teaching with Carol Plou and Anna Swinborne. The class was called Glimpses of Morisot, a study of 19th century French painting and poetry. And some of the imagery stems from the students at work on pieces inspired by works from that century in that country. This is a small plein air painting of the Piquabuck River. The Piquabuck stems off of the Farmington River, and it's done in one session directly from life. These two paintings are called Time Passages, and Jack of Hearts. This painting called Time Passages is built around the concept of kairos, time standing still, a moment when one can transcend, or one somehow does go beyond chronos and into a transcendent kind of healing space. This one called Jack of Hearts is a tribute to old friends, artists who have accompanied me and I them through the challenges of creating, of living a life as an artist. And the setting is a kind of Mediterranean space imagined, including a Chinese junk, and a boy reaching for the Virgin Mary and the Christ child. And finally, these three paintings on the fourth wall are called respectively Ephatha, Time Ago and What's Next, and The Bridge. Ephatha means be open. It's the word that Jesus spoke as he healed a deaf person. And the lilies also represent a kind of springtime or Easter feeling. This painting is based around the loss of Edward, the transformation of Edward from this realm to the next, as he passed away summer before last. And it's meant as a kind of healing work whereby the moon on the water, the fishermen, the artists at work, those reflecting and remembering through song and image, enjoy the remembrance of a fine soul. And finally, The Bridge, a painting about linking two different entities, a constant challenge as we carry the worlds that we each are assigned. And so on this beautiful late winter morning in Chelsea at the Bowery Gallery, take one last look. The sweep of the show, my third show here at Bowery Gallery, always a great honor to share the work with other distinguished artists, friends and family, and those who chance to come by and experience the work.